Hi, I'm Satik Ghosh, a graduate student at UC Davis's School of Education. This video will walk you through downloading and installing R and RStudio, and will showcase some of the basic functionalities of RStudio. Before we get to that, though, you might be wondering what the difference between R and RStudio is. R is a programming language. That means that it contains a library of commands that you can use to get your computer to output what you want. R is designed specifically with data analysis in mind, so a lot of its commands revolve around manipulating data. RStudio is an Integrated Development Environment, or IDE. It's an application you can use to keep track of your datasets, easily import files from your computer, and of course, use R itself. We'll show you around RStudio in a couple of minutes.
First, you'll want to download R. Go to www.rproject.org, find the CRAN link on the left, and choose the first link under Zero Cloud. You should now be on a page that looks like this. Now, choose the version of R that corresponds to your computer. I'm on a Mac, so I'll choose Download R for Mac OS X. If you're on a Mac, click the first link under Latest Release, r3.5.2.pkg. If you're using Windows, click the link that says Base, then click the top link on the next page. On a Mac, open the .pkg file and go through the installation process. On a Windows machine, open the .exe and install it. To download RStudio, go to www.rstudio.com. Click Download RStudio, and click the Download button under the RStudio Desktop Open Source License heading. Then choose the appropriate link depending on if you're using a Mac or Windows. The download should start. On a Mac, open the .dmg file, then click and drag the RStudio icon into the Applications folder. On Windows, run the .exe file and go through the installation process. Now that we've got R and RStudio installed, we're ready to start looking around. Before opening RStudio, let's take a very quick look at R itself. In your Applications folder, look for R and go ahead and open it. You'll see a window with a bunch of text about R, and at the bottom, a single arrow pointing right. You can use this to type in commands and press Enter to get output. You can see I put in 2 plus 2 here, and it output 4. With that in mind, let's take a look at RStudio. Open up RStudio from your Applications folder. On the left side, you might notice something familiar. This is the window you saw when you opened R. This is called the console. Now, in the bottom right, you'll see some files. This is your working directory. This is where all your files related to your project are. In the console on the left, type in getwd, then an open and close parentheses, then press enter. This should tell you the path to your project files in case you need to navigate to them through your Mac Finder or Windows Explorer. In the top right, you'll see your data objects. It's empty right now. Let's load a default R dataset by typing in cars equals MT cars into the console, then press enter. What we did here is we loaded one of R's example datasets, MT cars, into an object that we've named cars. This is a dataset containing aspects of automobile design. You'll see that cars appears in the top right panel. There are 32 observations of 11 variables. This means that the dataset has 32 rows and 11 columns. Click on cars in the top right panel. You'll see a new panel appear in the top left, showing an Excel-like spreadsheet with information about various car models. Each row corresponds to a different type of car, and each column is an attribute of the car, like its miles per gallon, MPG, number of cylinders, CYL, and horsepower, HP. In your console, which is now your bottom left panel, type in summary, open parentheses, cars, close parentheses, and then press enter. Here, you'll see that R has output summary information about each variable in the dataset. For miles per gallon, MPG, we can see that the minimum value is 10.4, the first quartile is 15.43, the median is 19.2, the mean is 20.09, the third quartile is 22.8, and the maximum value is 33.9. This is a very basic example of an analysis you can do with R. R has a lot more built-in functionalities, such as plotting several types of graphs, running t-tests and chi-square tests, and conducting various types of regression. Since R is open source, thousands of researchers from all over the world have also developed additional packages for more specialized kinds of analysis. These packages are generally available to download using R directly.
This concludes our video series. To get a more in-depth and hands-on experience using R for analysis, be sure to take advantage of the next workshop available.